somewhere in September, and the sun was going down when I came in search of coffee to a dusty river town. Come and have a drink, we'll call it. 'Tis a fitting name, I think. And refraining for a wonder up and come and have a drink. Underneath the pub veranda, I was resting on a bunk when a stranger rolled before me and he said that he was drunk. He apologized for speaking, there was no offense, he swore, but he somehow seemed to fancy that he'd seen my face before. He agreed you can't remember all the chaps you chanced to meet, but he said his name was Sweeney, people lived in Sussex Street. He was camping in a stable, but he swore that he was right. Only called the blanky horses treading over him all night. He'd apparently been fighting, for his face was black and blue, and it looked as though the horses had been treading on him too. But an honest genial twinkle in the eye that wasn't hurt seemed to hint of something better, spite of drink and rags and dirt. He was born in Parramatta, and he said with humor grim that he'd like to see the city ere the liquor finished him. But he couldn't raise the money, he was damned if he could think what the government was doing. Here he offered me a drink. Oh, I declined with self-denial and I lectured him on booze, using all the hackneyed arguments that preachers mostly use. Things I've heard in temperance lectures, I was young and rather green, and I ended by referring to the man he might have been. Couldn't stay to argue, for his beer was nearly gone. He was glad, he said, to meet me, and he'd see me later on. But I guess he'd have to go and get his bottle filled again. Then he gave a lurch and vanished in the darkness and the rain. And of afternoons in cities, when the rain is on the land, visions come to me of Sweeney with his